Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, and today on Superstar Save Point, we got somebody special. A good friend of mine from way back in the day. Samoa Joe!
In the flesh.
Wham! Now, Joe, on the show, everybody's got a nickname.
Everybody does have a nickname.
So is there something from childhood or something that you got now?
Do you have a nickname for me?
I don't.
You don't.
I mean, we could think something up.
We could.
I'm horrible at nicknames on the spot.
Yeah, you're really bad. I can already tell. Joey Headrocker, it is. You win.
All right, perfect.
Damn, that's a good one.
Perfect.
I can't even come up with that.
Perfect. I was thinking a bunch of like inappropriate stuff.
Yeah,
like,
I know you were.
All right, and today we're playing Sunset Riders.
Okay.
Okay, so Joe, if you don't know, Joe is big into video games.
Huge.
So, like, what are you playing right now?
What am I playing? So, just started Mass Effect.
Okay.
Andromeda.
Mm-hmm.
Ghost Recon Wildlands. Been co-oping that with a buddy of mine.
How do you like that?
So, I dig it. And so, we were comparing it to The Division.
Yeah.
Because,
yeah.
Like, I've been a big, like, I was on The Division, like, when I first saw it at E3. And mm-hmm. I was, like, all about it. And then The Division came out, and obviously, you know, and they really haven't still haven't got the, I don't know, they still haven't got the whole co-op console thing.
Yeah.
MMO thing. Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
Kind of figured out yet, but The Division's like a good start. But
yeah.
I'm looking forward to Destiny 2.
I have a feeling,
oh, Dynamite.
Come on. Were you big into the first one?
I think I was like everybody. Like, I wasn't, you first picked it up, and you're all about it.
Yeah.
And then, you realize, oh wait, I'm playing these same missions over every day all the time before the strikes came out. And then by the strikes came out, like, I was already off it. You
know? Yeah.
I was on something else.
Yeah.
It's like, it was tough. But then I revisited it, and I dug, like, the Iron King and all that stuff, too.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Big Show is huge into Destiny. Like,
I didn't even realize. Like, because, like, I was like, oh, you play video games? And then he started talking Destiny, and then he was like, oh, yeah, you do this strike. And this
yeah.
This. And I was like,
it's so funny. So he likes like Destiny and God of War and stuff. And so we'll be talking about it, but he'll see that someone else likes video games.
Uh-huh.
And be like, oh, you know, this and this. And he goes into all this intense stuff about the game.
Yeah, like real deep stuff.
Yeah, you know? Like, no, I casually play this game.
Yeah.
He's like
I kinda
so like deep
it.
In.
It's like when you like know somebody who's really into fighting games and stuff. And
yeah.
Like, they start going through all like, oh, well, that frame skip right there. And
yeah.
Then, you know, like, what the?
Like,
this
no.
Dude, and this dude's always trying to play footsies.
I'm like, oh. I'm just getting this pokes in.
Yeah.
Okay.
I just like to play Eddie Gordo on Tekken. What are you talking about?
So nice. So nice. The new one's coming out soon.
Actually, I'm a big Tekken head, man.
Yeah.
I'm Tekken, so I can't really talk. One time, AJ Styles almost ended his marriage because he would not leave a Tommy's hamburger with a Tekken machine because he couldn't beat me because I kept clowning him. Like, I was beating him, that was clowning him. And then I threw the game, and then he accused me of throwing the game. We had to play two more games.
You didn't want to have it
like
that. I just need one more game. So video games have been a big part of your life, and I think that's something that a lot of people don't understand. Like, mm-hmm. Yes, a lot of us love wrestling, but, like, video games are, like, just as important.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think it's, like, well, we're that generation that kind of came up with video games as part of our entertainment,
yeah.
Part of what we do. And so, yeah, like, I think... you know, it became this kind of crazy pastime. And it's funny because, like, you hear a lot of wrestlers, like, from back in the day. I don't want to say older wrestlers because it's not the truth. Because there's a lot of guys that, like you said, Big Show and cats like that.
Booker T, too.
Not that he's older.
Yeah, No, not at all.
That play tons of games and are all about it. Yeah, Booker too, man. Booker loves games.
Yeah.
So it's like, I'm better at bullet hells than this.
This is bullet hells is, like, all I've been playing the past few months.
Yeah, yeah. So it's like, I don't know. It's kind of, like, part of your entertainment now. You
mm-hmm.
know, some people like movies. Some people... you know, like TV shows, some people like it all, but I mean, a lot of us kind of dug video games as our pastime.
Yeah.
Kind of, especially when you decompress, when you're on the road, there's nothing better than, like I said, like I think the deal is, and I was talking to a couple other dudes the other day, it's like, you end up in a car with, you know, you travel with two other dudes,
mm-hmm.
you know, you end up with a car with a bunch of guys, and you don't really have a lot of, like, alone time, so then,
yeah.
Video games like a great way to spend time alone but still keep your mind occupied
yes.
and like kind of have that like quiet private time to kind of decompress.
Yeah, I was talking to one of the ladies that works like in the office side of things, and her kids really love Guitar Hero.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, I've never played video games. I may have done like the Duck Hunt one time.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay.
Don't you hate when like people like talk about like video games and be like, the
yeah.
like whatever that name, Super Mario Man. It's like, stop it. You know what the name is. Like,
you get
know,
it.
You get it.
But she's like, yeah, I started playing Guitar Hero and I became obsessed with it. And she said, when she gets home, that's also. Oh, We're out. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, just like that.
All right, yeah, perfect.
Okay, well, cool.
She was like, that's all I do when I get home because it uses a different part of my brain. Mm-hmm. At work, I'm on the computer, I'm setting up this, I'm setting up that. Mm-hmm. When I go home, I'm playing Guitar Hero, I'm in this different zone. So yeah, I think people that like aren't necessarily into video games and everything, it only takes them a hot second.
Yeah.
Once you start playing something and it you're clicks.
This is
we're dropping the logs.
The sad part is I used to be really badass at like the arcade version of this game.
Stuff gets hard, man. Yeah. Well, I don't think we realized how hard these games were back in the day.
I remember when I used to classify games by how much money I would average to complete it. And this used to be a $2 game. Like, I'm playing like it's a $5 game or two.
We got the unlimited continue, so yeah. I think we're just going to burn it out. That's how, so once we got this, the X-Men game came out like on Xbox, the old school arcade one.
Yeah.
I'd never actually beaten it in the arcade.
Yeah.
You just couldn't. So much money. But we beat it, and we realized that we totaled up the tokens that we would have used, and it would have been like $70. So hard.
Isn't it sad, like, because the arcade was like a big thing when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Like, it was a spot, like, it was where you hung out, like, where things went off, and like, I understand why it died, but it's kind of sad that they're not as prevalent as they used to be.
Yeah. The cool thing that's coming back, like, is like the barcades.
Yeah.
Like,
we just went to one, man. Like, where were we at? Where were we last?
In Philly?
In Philly, yeah.
Okay,
to
yeah.
Barcade in Philly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's a shout out there.
Bam. Barcade Philly, man. It's a great place.
So we're in Orlando right now. WrestleMania weekend. We're so excited. But to Joe's point, like, you guys know, finding barcades or arcade bars, we've been told, since barcade is an actual chain.
Yeah.
Arcade bars around the place, and there's some here in Orlando.
Yeah.
There's one Joysticks, I think it is, and they have like a Goonies room.
Yeah, that's gotta get actually pretty cool.
We gotta get over there. It's nuts. Yeah. As far as multiplayer games, like you said, you're playing Wildlands.
Yeah.
But is there anything like local multiplayer that you're into? Because I know we play a lot of UFC.
So all right, so there's this PC game, and you've played it. You know, it's Nidhogg.
Yes.
Come on,
it's great.
It's great. That's like there's trash being talked. There's all kinds of stuff. I was playing with actually got Zach Lowry, who works at Bosky now.
Yes.
He got him on it. Yeah, he quickly got way too good at it, like way too fast.
So you start getting mad at people, like, you're not supposed to be so good at this.
What are you doing, man? Like, I spent a weekend off, and he was like, he came back, he was like, dope at it. I was like, wouldn't even fun of him anymore. See, we're already $5 in.
Okay, so Nidhogg. Mm. Let me get deep into that. Have you played, what is it? It's like Nidhogg.
You talking about the unicorn with the whale thing, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Which, when I saw that, I was like, I thought you like had a hand in there. Like, it's a narwhal. It's got a unicorn.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, okay, whatever.
I saw it at my friend's party. I was losing my mind because like it's so ridiculous.
Yeah, and it's, you know, easy to pick up, hard to master type of deals. Yeah.
So are you're into games like that? Have you played like Dive Kick?
Yeah, I played Dive Kick. Which like it took me a spell to get it.
Yeah.
And then once I did, I was like, all right, this is pretty dope.
Yeah. All that stuff is really fun. There's a game that we play a little bit called Oh Sir, and it's the insult simulator where you're just very politely insulting people in like a British accent. People who make the best insults win, but it's set up like a fighting game where like you do damage and take like their life away and stuff. But there's some weird good stuff out there. Okay, so for new stuff, that's what you're playing.
Yeah.
Older stuff, like what's like your favorite game?
My favorite game,
Or like top three if it's too hard.
Yeah, that's way too hard. Yeah. So top three, like I'll go like most memorable because like I really, my tastes vary and like I like different games for different reasons.
Yeah.
So the greatest Final Fantasy of all time, 6.
Okay, you're a 6 guy.
Yeah,
fair. That's
right. Yeah, see how tight you got.
Well, I mean, like I'm a 7 guy.
Yeah, of course. 7 is, dude. 7 is Sephiroth had what? Oh, I was genetically engineered, and I'm pissed.
Yeah,
like, come on, man.
He's
that's
mad.
Not a story.
That's such a story. Man, Eris dying.
Six. Every man. The sub characters have better story than him.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh my god. All right.
We're gonna fist fight.
We agree to disagree. This is very difficult to do. That's a whole other video.
I would agree that you're wrong and I'm right.
I don't know about that. I don't know about all that. Seven's so good. Seven's iconic because 6 didn't bring people into the fold. 7 did.
It was a showpiece for a new system, man. It was a graphic show, man. Of course, yeah.
And it was amazing.
But you know, 6, we talk about substance and great storytelling.
Kefka in 6?
Yes.
Okay.
And the best heel in any Final Fantasy game ever, Like he had no angst. He wasn't like an emo kid. Like no, he was a straight evil. He was a gangster.
I will take that. Okay, I do like my villains evil with no redeeming qualities.
Yeah, he had none.
Yeah,
he was a scumbag from the get.
You already know.
Yeah.
Okay, so Final Fantasy VI.
Let me think here. Other big. It's tough. It's really. It's like, so I'm much. Trying to think of like like I've played so many games like. You know the worst part is I'm going to give you some games and I'm going to think of something that's 10 times better the minute we're done.
Yeah. as soon as we walk it out.
Yeah.
Oh, dang it. Dang it. We were fine.
There was this volleyball game.
Dead or Alive? Beach
no,
volleyball?
No. It was older. It was like in Nintendo days.
And I remember, Super Volleyball?
Yeah. Remember they had like the two buff dudes?
Yeah.
Like different, that game was ridiculous, man. Like that became like an issue like at my house. And and this is actually a good role game for the boys. Like when we were in Japan, we used to play the K-1 kickboxing game.
Okay.
You know, we got the UFC here and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But the K-1 kickboxing game in Japan, AJ will attest to it.
Yeah.
It was ridiculous.
What system is it on?
It's PlayStation. So it was PlayStation K-1. And it was just like, I remember me and at the time it was like Rocky Romero, Ricky Reyes, all those guys are Cubans and some other dudes and TJ.
Yeah.
And I mean, it became like, that was the game to play. Like, all the trash was talked. And like, if you really wanted to show out, you picked up Giant Yan Norte because he was like the slowest, like wackest.
And that's how you get it.
Yeah. And if you won with Yan Norte, like you, that was like ultimate disrespect.
We got to pick that up then.
Yeah.
We have PlayStation stuff. We're going to do like a retro day.
Oh yeah. That's
which blows my mind still like, PlayStation 1 is like retro now. I'm like, come on, man.
Yeah, it's like, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
It's like when you hear music that you love on the radio station, like, that was the classic hip-hop Mega Mix. Like,
yeah.
What?
Like, no.
Nothing classic about that?
Yeah. That DMX song Damien came on the other day. We were like, oh. And they're like, yeah, welcome to the old school.
Yeah,
rap.
Old school. Like, oh, no. Man. What are you talking about?
DMX is old school now?
Yeah. And then you realize, like, DMX got, like, six kids.
Yeah. The reality show. Yeah. Like, come on. Okay, speaking of DMX, hip-hop, you're a little bit of a hip-hop head too yourself,
yeah,
yes?
Yeah.
Anybody you listen to currently or back in the day that you're still bumping?
So, I mean, like, I'm partial to West Coast hip-hop, obviously. So, I mean, you know, all the usual suspects. There's Dre, Snoop, Kendrick's dope, you know, like, I still don't think Kendrick's had that, like, memorable, like, forever, but, you know, he hasn't had his nothing but a G thing yet, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
But I think he is coming, you know.
We had a talk the other day because someone was talking about how in hip-hop, people were trying to crown the guy.
Yeah.
And it was like a debate between, like, Jay-Z and Kendrick. Like, who's the king? And it was very interesting. Like, he's more of a hip-hop head than me, so he had a lot more to say about it. But I just hearing people that are eloquent in the world of hip-hop talk about it was very interesting.
I think that's a bad comparison because, like,
different
Kendrick's, like, if you want to talk about kings, like, Kendrick's, like, the best knight. You know what I mean? Like, nobody can mess with him, like, one-on-one. But you want to talk about the king, I mean, Jay-Z owns the castle, the kingdom, the horse he rode in on. Like, you know, distribution. So, I mean, that's tough. But, I mean, you know, if you want to talk lyrically, I mean, you know, it's a tough comparison. In that, like, he doesn't have the catalog yet.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I love
He's got the skills, but... Yeah.
It's interesting, too, because speaking of, like, West Coast rap, like... You could see, like, back in the day how people's styles were so different, and you could kind of, like, understand, like, oh, you know, well, the world is a much bigger place back then.
Yeah.
So, like, these styles being different makes a lot of sense. So, like, the fact that the styles are still so different, but the world is so much smaller now, kind of, like, baffles me, because you can even listen, like, just Kendrick's voice. You can tell West Coast rapper.
Yeah.
You hear Jay-Z voice. Okay, you know, from the Northeast.
But like a lot of hip hop now is kind of like you're getting a little bit of cross genre with how the beats are, especially with the, like you're getting like a lot of like southern trap music in the Northeast. And,
yeah, which is
weird. The electronica, you know, the EDM stuff. Like,
yeah,
has like infiltrated completely. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's into a lot of more poppy hip hop. But so I don't know. It's like I think you're getting a lot of people who grew up listening to a lot of different artists, and instead of like kind of taking their regionality. As far as what they want their sound to be, they're taking what influenced them growing up, and they made that their sound. So I don't think there's really a Southern sound, a West Coast sound, an East Coast sound, not as clearly defined as it was like in the 90s and stuff.
Yeah, that stuff was serious. Like Quad City DJs.
Yeah.
Favorite TV show currently?
Currently.
Currently.
you know, honestly, the one that I actually look forward to watching is it's Game of Thrones, man.
Yeah.
Like, I hate to be the cliche, it's like everybody else in the world, but it's a great show, man. Like, I dig it a lot, and like it's something I look forward to seeing every
year. Yeah. You know? Who's your favorite character? And are you all the way caught up?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All beyond caught up. I like the Hound, man.
Yeah.
I think I like the. Oh, spoiler alert.
It's fine. We did an episode. We just
in that case.
Spoiler he's back. Thing. No, no.
Yeah, he's cool, man. I dig the character. I dig kind of his intentions and his whole deal. I think he's the most honest cat in the whole deal.
Yeah. See, he's interesting to me because like he is such like a scumbag, but yeah. He's got this like heart of gold kind of with what's her name? Arya.
Yeah.
But he's done so many horrible bad things throughout his life. But just another guy trying to make it.
Yeah. Okay. Get along in the world, man.
Yeah, that's all we're trying to do. Everybody's just trying to get over. But cool. You know, I'll let you go.
Yeah.
We got to go too. That's Joey Headrocker, ladies and gentlemen.
In the house.
Give him a round of applause. Thank you for being
clap,
on.
Clap at home.
Yeah.
Yourself.
Some of this. Mom, okay. Let me say round of applause. Yeah. Give me a legit round of applause. At some point, we'll get you in and get you in the VR setup.
Oh, we're going to do some crazy stuff.
That's the good stuff. Oculus Rift, baby.
Yeah.
You can follow Joey Headrocker on Twitter at
Samoa Joe.
Bam. You follow your boy Austin Creed on Twitter at Xavier Woods PhD. Follow the channel on Instagram and Twitter at UpUpDownDown without the O's. Like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. But most importantly, make sure you always and forever keep it tight. Catchphrase. Getting in. Yeah, yeah. Ripping it. End scene.
Trademark.
Yes. Bye. Sweet, man. Thank you very much.